Oh yeah. All right now. This is a very sad story, but I gotta sing and tell it to you. Oh yeah. There was a boy, an infant baby boy. His mother named him Joe. He was her only child, her pride and joy. Heaven knows how she loved him so. She would have given her life for him, done almost anything. Oh, she tried to raise him right, but the boy just wouldn't listen. Oh no, 'cause he was too stubborn. The boy, he just wouldn't listen. There was no father around. He had walked out on them long ago. Joe grew and knew all the bad deals that went down. The men that became his role model were running from the law. They were always in big trouble. So she took him to church and Sunday school. She taught him the golden rule. Son, please stay in school and don't play the fool. But the boy just wouldn't listen. Oh no, 'cause he was too stubborn. Oh yeah. The boy, he just wouldn't listen. Joey, my son, you could hear his mother cry. Will you please listen to me? Stay away from drugs, guns, dons, and guns. Those friends that are bad company. I don't want you to die, young Joe. I don't want to mourn my only child. Please don't let me ban my belly. Will you please listen to me? Oh, Joe, you know that I love you so.
He was too stubborn.
Oh, yeah. The boy, he just wouldn't listen. Oh, no.
He was too stubborn.
Well, breaking news, my friends. At the very tender age of only 19, Joe is with us no more. Yes, Joe is dead. From gunshot wounds to his chest and his head. From a gun that was made and licensed to kill by the system. Maybe if Joe had only listened and taken heed to his mother's desperate pleas and her prophetic warnings, maybe he would not have ended up another victim of one of the system's guns and his own wrongdoings. Now, at his funeral,
boy,
Joe was listening.
Listen.
Yes, he was listening.
In fact, for
the first and only time, he was forced to remain still,
boy,
obedient and well-behaved. And listen as the preacher gave all of his surviving gang members, his surviving dons, dealers, and friends, the same warnings of a similar fate that might also befall them if they too would not begin to listen to their elders and mothers' wise counsel and act accordingly. Joe was also forced to listen to his very heartbroken mother and to his young teenage baby mother grieving, weeping and mourning while his infant son sat up in his stroller gently, innocently and peacefully smiling while carelessly playing with a toy. Completely helpless and oblivious to the dangers of the poverty and the harsh reality of being a poor, fatherless child, coupled with an insecure future that now mercilessly awaits him. But my friends, the very sad truth and reality was that to Joe, the preacher's admonitions and warnings, honor thy father and thy mother that thy days may be long upon the land, his grief-stricken mother mourning, his teenage baby mother weeping, his friends, fellow gang members, dons and dealers sobbing and hissing their feet as if thinking of and wanting revenge, and his infant child playing made no real difference to him now. For even though he was being forced against his will to remain still and listen to words of correction, words of wisdom and encouragement, the dumb fool was still not hearing a word, because there he laid, dead stiff in a wooden coffin, going 6 feet under. Yes, he's gone 6 feet under. Oh yeah, he was trying to be cool, so he dropped out of school, start running with that tool, and then he died like a fool.
He was too stubborn.
Oh yeah, and he's gone 6 feet under. Oh yeah. He played the fool.
Boy,
he's now 6 feet under. My youths, please don't let your parents and loved ones cry, weep and mourn at your funerals anymore, just
boy,
because you
just
have chosen to play the fool with your lives. You are much smarter than that. You work much more than that. You can do much better than that. So why not make them proud? Why not make us all your people proud? I am the Mystic Philosopher.